Good day, I'm your humble narrator, Sam. Go fuck yourself, alright?
I'm your humble narrator, Sideshow Bob.
I'm your humble narrator, Sideshow Bob. And with me here today is some.
Bart Simpson.
Oh, dead body.
Well, G-Man. I don't know.
And with me here today is a fuckhead Australian. And. Yeah, I'll shut you up, didn't it? Dick.
You little shit.
But yeah, so, fuck that!
What?
It was right behind the door!
I'm fairly sure it used to be able to open doors. Oh. Well then. You're just like, I'm gonna stand here and cry.
But yeah, no, okay. Let me explain. You may remember that in the last episode, shit wasn't working right. Everything kept crashing, and we ended up giving up. Here's what happened. Bump mapping happened.
Yeah, apparently SCP Containment Breach, even though it doesn't look like it has much bump mapping, it decided it was going to be a complete
bump
shitlord.
Bump.
Can I say shit?
Can you say shit lord?
Yeah.
No, that is completely fucking inappropriate, you cunt.
Okay.
How
now that we know.
Look, okay.
I would have laughed so hard if the statue was right there.
Sculpture. Actually, yeah, I only found out recently the sculpture is actually the first SCP.
Really? The first SCP ever made?
Yeah, which is weird, because it's 173. I always thought that. Although, frankly, SCP-001 is a bit of a fuck with the format, so.
Isn't SCP-001 like, the book or the.
SCP-001 isn't. There isn't an SCP-001.
Well, there is, according to this. Awaiting declassification or blocked, and then there's the proposals for SCP-0001.
Yeah, but like that's the point, is that there actually isn't one right now. Although,
well,
one
of them is the sheaf of papers.
Which I like.
And the sheaf of papers, like, describes the other SCPs. So I think that's the real one.
No, because actually one of my favorite ones is, it's something that. By the time this video goes out, like, I haven't uploaded it yet, but I'm uploading a reading of some additional documentation to it tomorrow. Like, so we're recording this on Friday the 15th of August. So literally tomorrow, Saturday the 16th, I'm going to be uploading this reading of some additional material. Oh, hello. Let me guess, this requires a key card. How do I get
it? Oh, I think that's one of the exits or something.
No, it's not, look.
Oh, it's the.
I'm trying to figure
out. Oh, it's that! That's the, machine that turns things into,
drugs.
Other things, but I think you need a higher level,
Yeah, I figured. It's just thing, I was double-clicking, so I couldn't get through the, thing, so I couldn't actually read what I was saying. But no, yeah, one of my favorite, these additional materials I'm uploading, is, like, it's SCP-001, where it's, like, essentially a path that just keeps going forever. Like, it's a road.
Oh, yeah, that one. I read that one.
Yeah. And then it's got the additional documentation that explain a few things that I think are quite interesting. Now, from what I understand, among fans of the SCP foundations, of the SCPs, canon regarding the O5 Council is really, really headcanon-y. Like, you know, not everyone agrees on how the O Council behave, or what the O Council really are, or who the O Council are. But according to this one story, the O5 Council number one, have been alive since the 1800s. There's like, which I think is just kind of an accepted thing about the O5 Council. Because right. there's like several stories that have that as a point, that the O5 Council's been around since the 1500s. Not 1800s. So yeah, that's one thing.
I was about to say, 1500s.
The O5
Council. Long time.
The O5 Council, 1800s.
Hmm.
Oh, we found a lift.
Whoop.
Don't crash, don't crash, don't crash, don't.
Oh my god.
What?
Amazing.
Oh yeah, the fact it didn't crap. Oh.
Yeah, you need to be careful. Because the lizard's down here. That asshole lizard.
But no, yeah, so several things about the O5 Council. 1800's been around since. The other one is that they make all the SCPs. That no SCP has ever been found. But they've all been created by the O5. Oh, that's a pair of teeth. Yes, two gigantic fucking teeth.
Two gigantic teeth.
But no, yeah, but the O5 Council actually create all the SCPs. Which I think is an interesting idea.
Why would they do that?
Because the first ones they created...
Domination.
In this story, the first ones they created were, like, the pills that cure all diseases and the Fountain of Youth. Hence them being around since the 1800s and shit like that.
Yeah.
But then and as then time they... went on, first... Ah! Fuck me! Okay, no. That was the sculpture, wasn't it?
I don't... D934... Oh, that's you. Yeah.
Yeah, assume to be attacked by SCP... Okay, correct me if I'm wrong, that fucking Slender Man in front of me, didn't it?
I think so.
I'm clutching my box of cotton buds for comfort.
Why do you have a box of cotton buds?
Because I have an earwax problem.
Delicious.
I know, right? I don't eat anything else anymore.
You just eat your earwax?
Earwax. It started out with them making the good things, and then it became they accidentally, like while they were trying to make good things, they made awful shit.
What would actually be really cool is if they made good things, and then because of the good things that they made, bad things also, like they had all their own counterparts.
It's kind of a vague indication that might be the case. But yeah, like they start making the good things, and then they start accidentally, like they tried to make another kind of cure-all, they made the zombie plague. And then they just start making fucked up shit. Like, they make 236, which if you don't know is a girl. At the first turn, 236 is a girl.
Yeah.
God, those things are creepy. I'm sorry, I just walked past. Who's down here? Jesus. But yeah, they're like 236 is a girl who has to be like regularly physically and sexually abused in order not give birth to the devil.
That's terrifying. What was it? 273 or something?
236.
Okay. Why would you build something like that?
But then it also made, you know, 17 they also made them made 173. And then they made, God, those things are freaky!
Yeah. The fucking model for them is so bad. Like, what is with their knees?
Damn legs, though.
Okay, so this thing says, SCP-236 is a mini crab.
Okay, no, I'm getting it wrong. But, no, it might be 273. It's two something. I can't remember which it was, but they made like this one that's literally just like this girl has to be regularly physically and sexually abused in order for her to not essentially give birth to the devil and destroy the world. And then they made, they just made, like, all the... But yeah, then they ended up just making like all the awful shit in the world, basically. And then,
the gayest man alive.
That's an SCP. Anyway, and then they established that shit just started appearing of its own accord. But again, it wasn't like discovered. They didn't find it. Stopped animating.
Yeah, looks like he's just standing there.
How do, buddy? I can't move right now. I mean, I can, but it's there. But yeah, and then like shit just started appearing. Essentially, and I believe the phrase is, things started appearing in containment, and they'd always been in containment. Well, that ends that fucking story.
Yep.
Let me guess. Just a minute.
He's a very cheerful individual who appears to be incapable of negative emotions.
Oh, it's gayest as in most happy.
Yeah, I was like...
Yeah,
considers good or gay, has some psychological attachment to the word gay. When asked to describe himself, he uses the word gay 6 times, gayety 4 times, and the word gayest once when SCP referred to himself as the gayest man alive. Oh, that's beautiful.
But yeah, no, then they just established that shit starts appearing in containment, and it's always been in containment. And then as it ends on a really, what I think of as a really harrowing line, which is, we aren't in control anymore. We never were. It's like, ugh! Then the other story about the O5 Council is kind of similar, that they made a lot of the SCPs, but not all of them. But yeah, no, the O5... I like the O5 Council, because no one can agree on what they are. Which I suppose, if you read into it in-universe, that might be deliberate. If you think about it in-universe, because no one's supposed to know who the O5 Council are. So if there's, like, conflicting stories as to who and what they are and how they operate, you know?
Right.
Hey, buddy.
Oh, God. Run away, run away. You can do it. Oh, that's the start of the game, right? So he never kills you there.
He can, actually.
Well, that's if you stand up right in front of him and are like, yo, dude, what's up?
Yo, my nigga. Yo, my nigga. Yo. Sorry.
Wow.
If you just show up and say, yo, my nigga, to him, he will kill you.
He's just like, fuck you.
Fuck you, old racist ass white boy. Why does it sound like Godzilla's attacking? Seriously. I'm still trying to figure out. Howdy.
You can do it.
What the hell are you?
One thing I've heard, actually, one thing I've read recently is I've been reading up on how, like, the SCP Foundation community actually reacted to SCP Containment Breach.
Huh? How did they?
The general consensus is, why is it all early SCPs? Like, why is it all from Series 1?
Maybe he hasn't found a good way to implement SCPs from later series, maybe.
And the rest of it's, like, continuity questions. Like, why the fuck are all of the dangerous ones in the same facility?
Yeah, that is also a good question.
Who the hell is that?
But that also, like, you kind of have to, otherwise there's no point. Like, the game becomes really easy. You know? Like, you need to have... Like, I actually reckon that the game only needs the old man and...
No! Hold it! Nope.
Good job.
I am the best!
I reckon that the game only needs the old man and the sculpture. Just increase slightly the, like, sculpture, his appearance rate.
And his size.
And his size. Yeah, maybe. But yeah, like, just in... make him more of a threat, and then just remove everything else.
Make him Godzilla.
Yeah.
I want a Godzilla sculpture. You know why?
What?
It'll be really inefficient. It wouldn't be able to kill anyone. Think about it. Sculpture the size of a building.
It wouldn't be able to snap anyone's neck.
No, it wouldn't be able to move.
Oh yeah, because everyone's looking at it.
Yeah. What?
939 again.
Huh. That. What?
What?
I didn't move. I was completely stationary. It just fucking ate my head. That's what she said.
So yeah, I can't actually, like, see the one that you mentioned.
You can't see what? The girl?
The one that you mentioned. The small child one. But I found, like, a witch.
She's not a small child.
She isn't?
No, she's just a young girl. Young woman. In her 20s.
This one is,
And she had, like, the 7 of them.
This one requires regular feeding every 12 hours, otherwise she becomes, like, combustible.
Give me burgers before I burn.
Yeah, pretty much.
But does she combust it underwater?
I have no idea.
Oh, I'm so dead. I feel like I'm doing the fucking on the ground shuffle.
You are.
I'm doing the spy crab. That's what I'm doing. I'm doing it.
And then you die. Die, damn it.
Stop that.
The cancer plague? Cancer isn't a plague!
There is an SCP, a more recent one, that's a guy who, it's like a presidential election campaign that shows up every now and again, and the main, like, goal of this non-existent candidate is, I shit you not, to, like, make everyone so fat they're immobile.
Wow.
There's also one of my favorite, I think it's actually classed as safe. SCPs is Reagan cut up while talking. It's like a tape of a Reagan speech where he starts saying, like, horrible satanic shit.
Hello. Yeah.
And he starts getting, like, mutilated, it, like, you know, cuts and shit start appearing on him in the tape while he's giving the speech. And then, like, one of the last tests they did, a guy in a black hood was pointing at them and text flashed up on the screen saying, I can see you.
Oh.
And they were like, yeah, we're not testing this anymore. We're done with that one. I think, yeah. We're going to put that in a box and pretend it doesn't exist. Forever. So. Should I save it and see if I can sneak around?
You should always save and sneak around. You could also die. Whoa, wait a minute. Is he, like, stuck?
Lollipop, lollipop. Ah, my fucking... I'm bleeding. Lollipop.
Looks like you are bleeding.
He was stuck, yeah. Darkness imprisoning me. All that I see, absolute horror. I cannot live. I cannot die.
I cannot die.
I bought the movie right. That is the one where they had to use clips from the film, like that from that one film with the guy with the box on his head, wasn't it? And they had to like.
That's like the first song that I learnt how to full combo on Guitar Hero.
And I'm fairly certain that they didn't for that one music video. Didn't they have to actually like buy the rights to the film?
I'm not certain. Then again, I don't know much beyond the music.
I was gonna say that better not be the fucking same lift I came down in. Fuck that.
What?
I pressed that button for that lift and it said, oh, the button doesn't do anything. Then when I'm walking away, fuck that. Well, I have to, don't I?
Yeah.
You know, I imagine you'd be we'd be reacting much more in sync if there was some way for you to hear what's going on.
Yeah, but, sadly, no.
Because, yeah, like, literally, there's one of the things on the other side of this wall. So when I move, it freaks the fuck out.
Oh. Why can it still see you, or...
It can't, it can hear me. Let's give
this
one a go.
You.
Let's give this a go, shall we?
Okay. Onward!
No loading screen. Odd.
Could you have gone back the way you came? What?
I think the old man's manifesting behind me.
Well, turn around and look.
No.
Do it! Do it, you...
Fuck!
Is he there? Come on!
Where's my heart medication?
Come on! Pansy! Come on! Let's go! We've got places to die at. In. Come on!
Okay, I'll stop pretending to be dead.
Come on, por favor.
Don't you fucking por favor me.
Por favor. Can't you escape from the pocket dimension?
Huh.
What?
The fucking computer just... you know, the old AI?
Oh, yeah.
I think it just gave me shit for having the game paused.
Yeah, it does that.
It just went... pausing. I forgot how much this game enjoys fucking with you.
Yeah, it does, doesn't it? Likes to be a bitch. Come on. Be a man. be a man, you must be swift as a coursing river, with the strength of a great typhoon, something. Raging fire, mysterious as the dark side of the moon.
And then, I start eating garbage. I'm the trash man.
Come on! Did they send me daughters when I asked for sons? You're the saddest British man I ever met, but you can bet before we're through, Mr. I'll make a man out of you.
So, I hope you enjoyed watching that video as much as I enjoyed making it. Let's be honest, I'm not kidding anyone, I don't know if I enjoyed it, I'm a pre-recorded message. Regardless, if you did enjoy it, please like the video, subscribe to my channel, and leave a comment below. I do read every comment I get. I need some form of validation for spending as much time as I do making these fucking things. If you want to see more of my stuff, please have a look around my channel. I've been making videos for years now, so there is a lot of content to see. I also try to upload once a day, 5 days a week, often with some side stuff going on over the weekend, so you may want to check that out. If you wish, you can follow me on Twitter, where I've been known to post inane bullshit on a semi-regular basis, and if you're feeling particularly generous, you can always subscribe to my Patreon campaign. Every subscriber on there brings me closer to not having to get off my fat ass and get a real job. And I'll eventually be able to upgrade my PC and all that shit. Well, that's it for this pre-recording. Hope to see you all in the next video. Now, get the fuck out. This one's over. Leave. Now.